Hello, I'm Aaron, an engineer on the Steam team. Today I'll be talking to you about branches, what they are, and how you can make use of them in your game. Let's get started.
Branches are versatile tools for managing different versions of your game. We call them branches in Steamworks, but they're also known as betas in the Steam client. They're widely used to control development workflows, reduce risk when releasing and testing major updates, and to assist when balancing multiplayer gameplay. A common way to use branches is to create a preview branch so that a small set of your players can test out an upcoming version of your game before you're ready to release it to the general public. You can allow anyone to use the preview, or you can only give access to a selection of your players. One particularly great use for branches is when your game has mods. When you make a major update that could potentially break existing mods, you can create a branch for the prior build so that people can still play your game with their favorite mods while mod developers work on updating them to your newest build. Branches can be public or password protected. Password-protected ones, hidden ones, are super handy for keeping early builds under wraps. There's a special branch called default, which is where everyone starts off on. The primary version of your game will be on the default branch, and this is what players will download when they first buy your game. From there, players can choose to switch to a different branch that they have available to them. The Steam client will download that new build automatically. One thing I want to mention that's recently changed is about hidden branches. Hidden branches used to be a bit less hidden than we wanted. Their names were visible, and people could see when you updated them so they could potentially tell that you were in active development in a particular area. Developers have been asking us to fix this for a while, and it's recently been approved so that hidden is now properly hidden. Okay, let's walk through a quick example. Say you have a preview out to your customers. You can see it here as build number 75. You then make some improvements and push a new build, which you upload to Steam as build number 84. Once that build is ready, you can set it live on the preview branch. Your customers that are using the preview branch will automatically start to download the new build. All right, some other things related to builds and branches. A long-requested feature is that developers wanted to interact with branches from within their game. This was recently added. So now, let's say that your game loads up mods on startup. It notices that these mods it loaded were incompatible with the version of the game the user is currently playing. With this API, you can find a branch where they would work and help the player switch to it. You can automate uploading builds to Steamworks. You set up your build site to publish Steam on success. There's even an option to automatically make builds live on a branch such as your daily playtest branch upon upload. Then anyone in your studio can have access to that through the Steam client. One limitation to be aware of is that you can't automatically switch the default branch without an additional authentication step. This helps avoid situations where an account is compromised and someone attempts to upload an incorrect build. It's a little bit of extra friction, but it's there for a good reason. LAN cache is a cool tool that the Steam client has built-in support for. It's a transparent caching proxy that you can set up to speed up your build distribution times within your game studio. Once you set this up, your Steam client will read from LAN cache. LAN cache will try to find content in its cache and fall back to reading from the Steam servers if the content isn't present. LAN cache can make it faster for playtest machines to get new builds, for instance. It doesn't affect how you deploy to Steam, it's just during development. Something interesting to note is that Steam only keeps data on your PC for one build at a time. So if you're switching builds a lot, it can be a major speed up to not have to go all the way to the Steam servers to get your bits every time you switch branches. To wrap it up, branches are a flexible tool for development, testing, and release management. They provide a way to isolate changes, test features in parallel, and manage access, whether for internal QA or public previews. With support for both private and public visibility, branches can help teams stage and validate updates before pushing them live. We've seen them used for a wide range of workflows, and we hope they'll be useful in yours too.